I guess. Recording a little video here, because I just got something in the mail. Pretty exciting, yeah. You know, if you watched my previous video, you'll see that, I was cleaning dust out of my video card. You know, I put it back in. It ran great for a day or two, but then I came back to my computer and resumed it from sleep, and there was a ton of artifacts on my screen, and the thing kept crashing, like, every couple minutes, it seemed, anyways. So I figured, well, I think the video card finally just gave out, you know, and that dust didn't help it at all. And I'm guessing, you know, that overheating damaged something that led to it to failing like that, because, I mean, when I took the thing out of the motherboard, the first time I touched the card, the whole card was freaking hot. It was warm. I was like, holy crap. You know, definitely something wrong here. Clean out the dust, you know, I was like, yay, you know, it's working. But then, a couple days later, it stopped working. Entirely. You know, I'm guessing maybe something with the memory got corrupt, because, like, I could see parts of my screen fine, but the rest of it was just artifacts. You know, I checked the connection to make sure there's no loose connection anywhere. It wasn't that. So, must have just been the video card. So, I decided, you know, I had an old video card laying around, like, threw in there, but that thing is just, pretty crappy. I'll just leave it at that. You know, you can't play games decently good. The only thing it's good for really is looking at your desktop. And even with this new, you know, Windows 7, and Vista, it had in Vista 2, but the new, you know, glass effects, you know, it was okay. It could run the glass effects, just not as good as my old card, for sure. But yeah, we got a new card here. Got in the mail just today, so excited. Here we go. I guess I'm gonna unbox it here on this video here. Here it is. Sapphire Radeon HD 5750. You know, I was looking around for some cards. You know, I wanted one that was a decent price range. This one was like almost at $100 exact, a little more than $100. And I didn't really want to spend more than $100, but these cards just keep going up, so I had to compromise and get one that was over $100. But you know, for the price performance ratio, I would say this card was looked pretty good online. Now we will put it to test and see if it really is living up to what some of the online reviews said about it. So I guess I'll just start unboxing this thing. Oh yeah, I just got a little penguin on the front of the case here. Radeon HD 5750. And yeah, you got your little logos and stuff, and as you can see in the corner, got a gigabyte of GDDR5 RAM. Big improvement from my previous card, which is only a 512 megabyte GDDR. I don't remember exactly, I think it was a 3 GDDR3, but this one's freaking 5. So I should be see a good speed improvement from that alone. Now, of course, it comes with DirectX 11, as it says down here in the corner. If my autofocus will focus, oh well, won't wait for that. Of course, PCI Express 2.0. Of course, Crossfire X ready. What ATI card isn't Crossfire ready? So yeah, I guess we'll just open this thing up. Okay, there we go. It's out of the box. But look at that, just another box. Okay. But apparently it's recycled. It's got a little recycling logo in the corner in case you care. But anyways, here, let's try to get this in the camera. I should probably like move this around, but oh, you can't see it, but oh, there's a CD there. Gotta have the drivers on it and stuff. And of course we got this nice foam protection inside. Gotta love the protection. See, even video cards need protection, people. Anyways, so yeah, driver disk. Cool. I just install the ones online, though. We got our quick install guide in case you don't know what the heck you're doing, which is nice, because not everyone knows what the heck they're doing. Some people have never installed a card before. What's this? We got a Sapphire Select Club card here. I'll read about that later. Of course, we have our little DVI to VGA or D-cell, whatever you want to call it, adapter right there. Won't need that because I got LCD. Here's our little cord that of course adapts from your regular component power adapters into the 6-pin card thingy for your video card in case your power supply doesn't come with one. Mine has one of these, so I won't need to worry about that. Put this back in there. Well, won't waste your time. Here's a little bridge thing in case you have to have two cards. So Crossfire written all nice there, and the freaking autofocus is not working too well on my camera today. Okay, now we get to the main attraction here, which would be the video. Whoa, almost dropped the box there. The video card itself in this nice anti-static bubble wrapped bag. Of course, it says stop. You know, you must connect this graphics board to the computer's power supply. Yeah, no crap. But yeah, it's a nice little, you know, reminder, because I'm sure they have plenty of cards being returned to them. It doesn't work. Would you plug the darn thing in, people? Oh, you know, so I'm sure that's why that's there. So here we go. Oh. There it is. Vapor X. I can't read that from the screen. Vapor Chamber Technology Cooling. Awesome. Anyways, yeah, so there's the nice little fan right there in the center. A lot smaller than my previous card lengthwise. I like it, because I should have a lot more room in my case for the hard drive area. And of course you got your 6-pin plug back there for connecting your power into it. And pretty nice looking heatsink on there. I'll probably get a close up of this later with better lighting, because it's kind of hard to see. But there it is, people. My card. My new card. Now let's hope it lives up to its expectation. I'm sure it will. I mean, it's a newer model than my previous card after all. Although it's the 5750 instead of the 800 series, it's the 700 series. But it's still probably going to do everything I want. And then some. But there it is. I guess I'll just stop it now and hook it up. And then run some, I don't know, benchmarks or something. We'll see. But yeah, I'll just cut to that, I guess. Peace for now.
So on your old cards, you sort of remember this clip down here, because that thing will prevent it from coming out. So just make sure you push down on it, and the card should come out, you know, a lot easier. So here I am taking out the card. So yeah, it's gone. Good riddance, man. Because that thing was pretty crappy. So yeah, that's out. Now I'm putting in my new card. So here it comes. Ba-ba-da-boom. So there it goes. Putting it in. Looks like having a little difficulty. A little, just a little. But yeah, there we go. Got it in. Now, putting in the power plug. Make sure, you know, it has power. Can't forget that step. So, snapping it in right now. There it goes. Now, here comes the next part, which is, you know, screwing it in. Make sure your card's not going to wobble around and stuff. So, there I am, screwing it in. Alright. Now that that's done, now we are putting back on this, screw this thing that I took off of it because it just got in the way. So I had to take that away, or take that out while I put in my card. So here I am putting it back, and I, you know, clipping it back down, and then I'll screw that thing back in later. And, you know, that's pretty much all it takes to put it in. Awesome, huh? Yeah. So now we're going to the back of the card. We've got two DVI ports, HDMI, and DisplayPort. And here's a cool little light that's on the card. You know, I thought it was a nice addition. I didn't know that was there. So now onto the Windows 7 ratings. So here they are. We have 7.3 for our gaming graphics. Way nice. This is the highest thing on my system now. So, you know, I by no means have the state-of-the-art system. I mean, look how low my RAM is. But that's just because I only have 2 gigabytes. But that's a whole other issue. Anyway, so just look at those ratings. pretty nice. I'll say that.
This is a 3D Mark 11 basic edition benchmark test. I'm seeing how well this video card's going to perform. So far as looking, you know, the frame rates are decently smooth, and this thing looks pretty doggone amazing. I'll say that. So yeah, of course I'm just using my webcam to record it, so, because desktop capture software would, you know, mess with the benchmark results, so kind of have to record the screen, but oh well. It's almost loaded. Almost, there we go, it's done. White screen, whoa, look at that. It's looking pretty doggone good. Although you can definitely tell the frame rate's a bit choppy, but this is a benchmark. It's supposed to push your car to the max. One thing I have noticed is the fan on my car has actually remained relatively quiet during this whole process. I like it. Nothing more annoying than having some huge fan kick up, ramp up. But of course, you know, if you gotta have it done, then whatever, because you definitely want to keep your car in sane condition.
Alright, here's the results. Total score was a P2049. Here's the other specs of my system, you know, AMD Phantom, processor. You want to look at the exact models right there. Graphics card ATR Radeon HD 5750. One card, 1 GB of RAM, 710 MHz. Core clock. Here's a motherboard, BioStar, DA7, yada yada. All right, bye. 3 mark score. I already said it earlier. Graphics score was 2000. Physics score 2315. Combined score 2081. Graphics test 1, 10.03 FPS. Or frames per second. Graphics test 2, 9.77 frames per second. Graphics test number 3, 12.11 frames per second. Graphics test number 4, 5.71 frames per second. And physics test, 7.35 frames per second. And the combined total is 9.68 FPS.